We didn't see it coming. A story of redemption. What started in a manger ended in an empty grave. If you're searching, if you need healing, he's where you find it. Lay down your burdens and breathe in forgiveness. And if you need freedom, yeah, he's where you find it.
prays for peace on earth, and she's calling out from a sea of hurt. Oh come, Emmanuel. And can you hear the angels sing?
like a frost on a rose. Winter comes for us all.
How about these students? Don't they look fantastic? So on behalf of our Fine Arts Department, I want to welcome you to our annual Fine Arts Christmas Concert. We are so excited to have you all on campus as we celebrate the birth of our Savior and we watch our Bronco students who have worked so hard this semester. They put in so much hard work this semester as we watch them perform this evening. So my name is Les Rainey and I serve as the interim head of school here at Bay Area Christian School. And before we kick off tonight's program, I just want to thank several groups of people. First and foremost, I want to thank our teachers and our faculty and staff who do such a terrific job every single day. But most importantly tonight, I also want to recognize specifically our performing arts teachers, Miss Mary Ann Morrison, Mr. Glenn Gray, Mr. Randy Brennan, and Miss Elizabeth Hope. So thank you to those four for putting together this program. Next, we are so grateful and I'm always so impressed with our students here at Bay Area Christian School. They continue to excel not only in the academics, but also in the co-curriculars as well. And finally, I want to thank our parents. Thank you for the investment that you make in your child's education and in kingdom education. We are so grateful. It is no doubt an investment that has a generational impact. So again, thank you for coming out tonight in the frigid Christmas Southeast Texas weather. But no, seriously, we have a lot to be grateful for. So as we kick off tonight's performance, if you would, please join me in a word of prayer. So Father, it is with a sense of gratitude that we come before you this evening, Lord, grateful for all that you do for us, grateful that we can come together and celebrate the birth of our Savior. Lord, I pray tonight that you would just be with our students, that you would give them strength, that you would just give them focus. And Lord, I just pray a blessing over all of our families. Lord, I pray for this campus that you would just continue to protect us. And Lord, we are just so grateful for tonight. So in everything we do tonight, we pray that we would bring you honor and glory. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
weddings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time. Yes, the most wonderful time. Oh, the most wonderful time of the
the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, the mistletoe hung where you. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time of the year.
Have a holly jolly
Glad that y'all have joined us this evening. We have two more songs for you. And at this time, we are going to invite some choir alumni to come sing with us on this song. We also have a featured alumni soloist, Dr. Jessica Peck. So sit tight. It's going to be exciting. We are so proud of all of these students for the hard work that they've done. So just a couple more, and then we will move to intermission.
It's your baby boy is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nation?
Seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they pound, praising the sound, oh, hear the dance, hallelujah. Hey, they ring, all people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here. Ding dong, ding dong, that is the song. With joy, ring dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong.
Sweet summer bells all sing the same.
Seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they bow, praising the sound, all in the dell, telling the tale. Gaily they ring, all people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here.
Ding dong, ding dong, that is the song. With joyful ring, all is the
ding dong,
ding dong. On they say, on without end, their joyful tone to every
it's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time. Yes, the most wonderful time. Oh, the most wonderful time.
The best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, the mistletoe hung where you. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time.
Everyone you meet. Oh, ho,
We're having an instrument malfunction.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at the nose.
Are you turning it on or am I? Is it on? I give up trying to get this thing out of the holder. It's just too tight. Welcome to the band portion of tonight's concert. Really glad to see so many of you out here. We are packed in, and anymore, and we're going to have to start getting really, really close to each other. All right, the group in front of you now is our fifth grade band. When you start, you're considered a beginner. Ladies and gentlemen, this group right in front of you is about to do their first big monument. What is the word? The momentous occasion. They are no longer to be considered beginners. They have moved on their first year, yes, but they are not beginners. Give them a hand for this, please. And we're now going to try to show you a little bit of what they have been learning and what you have been suffering through the last few months.
Good evening. I am Mr. Gray, for those that do not know. And I missed the announcements because I was herding sixth grade over there. We've got quite a number of kids that were moving around. I'm sure that a lot of the parents, with this being for many of you your first concert, the kids' first concert, you've been hearing some interesting sounds that have come from their rooms, the garage, the shed in the back, wherever you kind of have them practice. So, in getting a chance to actually hear them with everybody, it's probably a little breath of fresh air. Again, it's a group of students who pretty much started playing their instruments around the beginning of September. You probably heard a lot of interesting sounds in those first few stages. As a saxophone player myself, I kind of know the pain that parents went through with beginning saxophone. My mom heard some very, very interesting sounds that came from beginning saxophone, and a lot of suggestions of, maybe you should do this when I'm not home. Then with hopes over the course of the next few weeks, it started making a little bit more sense. The noises started to become sounds. Those sounds started to become music. And then hopefully that music started to become a song. This next song that we're going to do is one that's entitled Christmas Fun. And it's actually a medley of a few different Christmas songs.
Thank you.
Is this? Oh, there we go. I got startled. I'm a big fan of my own voice, so I get a little rattled when I don't hear it. Seated before you now is our sixth grade band. Majority of these students, this is their second year in band, and we have a handful where this is their first year. Our first selection that we're doing is another Christmas medley. This one is entitled Songs of Christmas Cheer.
This next one is similar to Last Christmas because it's not a Christmas song. And you can argue with me all you want, but I still say it's a breakup song, not a Christmas song. This one is a song that we have used several times over the last several years. Every group has played it because they just love it. It's a great little tune. It's called Furioso.
Thank you. I'm a hundred dollars.
On stage now is our junior high band. The first piece that we played, obviously, is not a seasonal piece, but one that they'd been working on for a while, and that one was entitled Byzantine Dances. Next up is more of a traditional piece that, again, is a medley.
I'm dating myself, I'm sure. As I was growing up, there was a music publishing company called KTEL. If you remember that, and you can nod your head. KTEL was that version, that generation's version of, now that's what I call music, number 53,000, you know, they're doing. But in the TV commercials, they would play you about 2 seconds of each song. That's what this song is. It's 20 carols in 2 minutes. And you will hear no more than 4 to 16 measures, or 16 counts of any one song. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Before we get into their last song for the evening, I do want to recognize a few students. This past weekend, we had junior high region band auditions, and we had quite a large number of students that auditioned. Easily the largest number that we've had participate in auditions ever. And of those that auditioned, we had six that made that band. They were able to make one of three bands that will be performing in January. For that event, they were competing against, I think there was over 700 students that auditioned. And it was among small public schools, so it wasn't just a private school thing. But we did have six of our students that made those groups, and I'd like for them to stand right now. As you can see, we have some wonderful things going on in this group. This is my little shameless plug. I know that, you know, a lot of the students, when they go from 6th to 7th grade, like to switch to study hall, and I'm sure that's awesome and everything. When we become adults, we look back at the fun times that we had in study hall and all those things. So, I don't know, some of these that managed to stay in band and keep it going, I'm sure their stories are going to pale in comparison to those that decide to do study hall. Study hall. Thank you. As they are making their way back, we'd like to thank some of our guest artists for playing with us. Our high school principal, Mr. Payne. And our assistant director, Mr. Brennan. That last piece was one entitled, Fanfare and Procession on an Old English Carol. Obviously, we kind of recognized what that carol was. The next piece that the high school band will be doing is one made famous by the Trans-Siberian Orchestra, and that is Mad Russian Christmas.
Thank you.
Those of you that saw the groups at the last concert last year, kind of remember how we played along to videos and things like that. And at the time, I kind of thought it was kind of cool. Then afterwards, I kind of realized I kind of backed myself into a corner there. Because we had to do different things now. One of which is a telling of a story. Any student that I've ever taught knows my absolute favorite movie. Many of their parents know my absolute favorite movie. They know how obsessed I am with this movie. And how ever since I was in middle school, and they keep trying to find out when that was, and I will not tell them, I have watched this movie every day in the month of December since I was in middle school, without fail. My best friend, college roommate, hates the movie because it also meant that he watches it every day. My wife strategically stays away from the house until I kind of say something about, all right, just finished the movie, and then magically she shows up. The movie is Muppet's Christmas Carol. It is my absolute favorite movie. And in the process of rehearsing for this, I kept saying, the Marleys were dead to begin with. To which they all let me know that in
singular.
A Christmas Carol, there's only one Marley. Which then the kids found out that I've never actually read the book. So I'm admitting I have never actually read A Christmas Carol. Even though at the end, Gonzo himself, as Charles Dickens, says, if you like that, you should read the book. I'm not going to read the book. But for you all tonight, we have a special treat of A Christmas Carol.
Marley was dead to begin with. There is no doubt whatever about that. Scrooge and he were partners for many years. Oh, but he was a tight-fisted hand at the grindstone, Scrooge. A squeezing, wrenching, grasping, scraping, clutching, covetous old sinner. Once upon a time, of all the good days of the year, on Christmas Eve, old Scrooge sat down before the fire to take his gruel. His glance happened to rest upon a disused bell that hung in the room, and as he looked, the bell began to swing. Soon it rang out loudly, and so did every other bell in the house. The bells ceased as they had begun. On the floor below him, the cellar door crashed open with a resounding boom. There came a clanking noise deep below, as if some person were dragging a heavy chain. A ghostly moan echoed around him. The noise came straight up the stairs, straight towards his door. And through the heavy door, the ghost of Jacob Marley, dead these 7 years, passed into the room. The chain he drew was clasped about his middle. It was long and wound about him like a tail. It was made of cash boxes, keys, ledgers, and heavy purses wrought in steel. His body was transparent. What do you want with me? Asked Scrooge. Much. Marley's voice, no doubt. It is required of every man that the spirit within him should walk abroad among his fellow man. If that spirit goes not forth in life, it is condemned to do so in death, and witness that what it cannot share but might have turned to happiness. I am here to warn you that you have a chance and hope of escaping my fate. You will be haunted by three spirits. Remember what has passed between us. The curtains of his bed were drawn aside by a very small hand. I am the ghost of Christmas past. Rise and walk with me. They soon approached a mansion of dull red brick. The school is not quite deserted. A solitary child, neglected by his friends, is left there still. In a long, bare, melancholy room, a lonely boy was reading near a feeble fire, and Scrooge sat down and wept to see his poor, forgotten self as he had used to be. The scene changed, and his younger self sat by a fair young girl in a mourning dress whose eyes glistened with tears. A golden idol has displaced me. I therefore release you with a full heart for the love of him you once were. Have I ever sought release? In a changed nature, yes. May you be happy in the life you have chosen.
Spirit, why do you delight to torture me?
These are the shadows of things that have been. That they are what they are, do not blame me. Take me back, leave me, haunt me no longer. The ghost of Christmas Present sat upon an enormous Christmas bounty. He was a jolly giant, glorious to see. Come in and know me better, man. Spirit, conduct me where you will. Tonight, if you have aught to teach me, let me profit by it. Touch my robe. All of a sudden, they stood in the city streets on Christmas morning. There was cheerfulness in the very air. The people were jovial and full of glee, now and then exchanging a facetious snowball. The shops were radiant in their glory. The customers all hurried and eager in the hopeful promise of the day. Soon the steeples called good people all to church and chapel, flocking through the streets in their best clothes and with the gayest faces. The spirit spread his cheer abundantly among them all. The spirit stopped at the threshold to bless Bob Cratchit's dwelling. They were not a handsome family, but they were happy, grateful, and contented with the time, and looked happier still in the bright sprinkling of the spirit's torch. My life upon this globe is very brief. It ends tonight. Forgive me, spirit, but protruding from your robe, is it a foot or a claw? Look here. This boy is ignorance. This girl is want. Beware them both, but the boy most of all, for written on his brow is doom unless the writing be erased. Have no resource? No refuge? Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses? The bell struck 12. Scrooge saw the ghost no more. As the last stroke ceased to vibrate, Scrooge beheld a phantom, draped and hooded, gliding like a mist on the ground towards him. Ghost of the future, I fear you more than any specter I've seen. Lead on. The night is waiting fast and it is precious to me. Lead on, spirit.
No, I don't know much about it either way. I only know he's dead. What was the matter with him? I thought he'd never die. Well, old Scratch has got his own at last, eh?
Wicked old Scrimp. Why wasn't he natural in his lifetime? If he had been, he'd have had somebody to look after him instead of lying there, gasping out his last, alone there.
I am sure we shall none of us forget our poor tiny Tim, shall we?
My poor child!
A pale light fell straight upon a bed upon which was the covered body of a man, unwatched, unwept, uncared for. The phantom's hand pointed to the head.
I would do it if I could, but I haven't the power, spirit. I haven't the power!
The scene swirled about him, and they stood in a churchyard. The spirit stood among the graves and pointed to one. On it was written his own name, Ebenezer Scrooge. Spirit, hear me. I am not the man I was. I will honor Christmas in my heart and try to keep it all the year. Oh, tell me I may sponge away the writing on this stone. He saw an alteration in the phantom's hood and dress. It shrank, collapsed,
and dwindled down into a bedpost. It was his own. It was Christmas morning. The spirits had done it all in one night. He sent a prized Christmas turkey to Bob Cratchit's, then danced as he dressed all in his best and at last got out into the streets. He went to church, he walked the streets and watched the people hurrying to and fro and found that everything could yield him pleasure. In the end, Scrooge was better than his word. He did it all and infinitely more. He became as good a friend, as good a master, as good a man as any good old city knew in the good old world. It was always said of him that Scrooge knew how to keep Christmas well. And so, as Tiny Tim observed, say it with me, God bless us, everyone!
On behalf of the Fine Arts Department, I'd like to wish you all a very Merry Christmas. Christmas. Thank you so very much for coming out. We will see you all next time. Please take your kids home. I'm done now.
Thank you. so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Doesn't show signs of stopping. I brought some corn for popping. Lights are turned down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. Fire is slowly dying, and I hear we're still goodbye. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Lights are way down low, so let it